You've all heard this passage before, right? Some of you, okay, you know the song? Come up, we're going to sing the song. We're going to sing the song. Come, you doing motions, you're going to get called up. Come on. Don't make me come get you. Get up, come up here, and let's do the songs. Come on. If you can help them. Everybody stand up, we're going to do motions. We're going to sing a song, we're going to do motions. Come on.
I don't know all the motions. I don't know the song.
Do you know the song that comes from this? The wise man built his house upon the rock. The wise man built his house upon the rock. The wise man built his house upon the rock. The rain came tumbling down. The rain came down and the floods came up. The rains came down and the floods came up. The rains came down and the floods came up. And the house on the rock stood firm. The foolish man built his house upon the sand. The foolish man built his house upon the sand. The foolish man built his house upon the sand, and the rain came tumbling down. The rain came down, and the floods came up. The rain came down, and the floods came up. The rain came down, and the floods came up, and the house on the sand went pow! Now, we're going to do it one more time, and everybody has to sing. Come on, ready? Splash! That's right, that's the funnest part of the song. The wise man.
Wise man built his house on the rock. Wise man built his house on the rock. And the rain came tumbling down. The rain came down and the floods came up. The rain came down and the floods came up. The rain came down and the floods came up. And the house on the rock stood firm.
The foolish man built his house upon the sand.
Foolish man built his house upon the sand. Foolish man built his house upon the sand. And the rain came tumbling down. The rain came down and the floods came up. The rain came down and the floods came up. The rain came down and the floods came up. And the house on the hill.
Oh, you can do better than that, really? Okay, fine. Sit down. So, it's all about doing the right thing and building our lives on what God told us to build our lives upon, right? Right? That's what it's about?
This is where you kind of just pause for a moment and go, wait a minute, is this really what it's about?
This is an interesting passage of Scripture that is sometimes taken out of context.
As all Scripture is, when you pull it out and read this verse and say, this is what we're looking at tonight, right? These verses of the wise man heard and acted and built his house on the rock. And the foolish man did not hear and did not act and built his house upon the sand. See, the difference between these two men is what?
Hearing.
Not hearing. They both heard it, right? And everyone who hears these words of mine then will be like a foolish man. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act. Everyone who hears these words of mine and acts is like a man who built his house upon a rock. Everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act is like a man who built his house upon the sand. Both of them heard it. Plain and clear. How many of you are happily married? Okay, let me rephrase that question. How many of you are married? How many of you know somebody that's divorced? Now, this couple that's divorced, the kids, you just play along here for a moment. This couple that's divorced, do they have any more problems than you if you're happily married? No, they don't. Absolutely not. The happy couple, the couple that stays married, like these two fine young people back there in this row sitting right here. Because you learn how to deal with each other. It's not because you don't have conflict. It's not because you don't have trouble. It's not because you don't have strife. It's because you figured out over the years there's things you have to do and there's ways you work around it. Marriage is not always easy. It's like life. That's the way things happen. The couples that get divorced have no more problems than the couples that stay married. Those of you, there are several people I know who have been divorced and remarried. Divorced and remarried. Christ is about, hearing and seeing where this passage comes from. This passage in Matthew tonight, in chapter 7, is the end of a two long chapters in the book of Matthew that is, anybody tell me, start at the beginning of chapter 5?
Yes.
So we ask you to start the Sermon on the Mount. Chapter 7 ends the Sermon on the Mount. So, what Jesus is saying here, those who have heard my words to the 5,000 or however many were gathered to the Sermon on the Mount, to those who hear my words here, to be salt and light, to know that Jesus didn't come to abolish the law, but he came to uphold it, that he taught us not to think bad thoughts about our brothers and sisters. It's not enough just not to murder, but we can't think bad thoughts about anyone around us. We have to stay committed to the one that we're with. We're not supposed to get divorced. We're not supposed to create oaths. We're not supposed to go for an eye for an eye or to go for retaliation. We're not supposed to hate our enemies, but we're supposed to love them. We're supposed to give alms. We're supposed to pray. We're supposed to fast. We're supposed to store our treasures where moth and rust are not going to take them away. We're not supposed to serve money and God. We're only supposed to serve God. We're not supposed to worry. We're not supposed to judge. We're not supposed to profane the holy name of God. We're supposed to do unto others as we want them to do to us. And everyone who has heard these words of mine and does them, exactly. Christ is calling us to be like him. It's not about saying that who's ever heard these words. That's where it gets taken out of context. It's not about the whole book. It can't be about the whole book. But it's really a session about those two chapters of Jesus' teaching on the mountain, which in and of itself, if you go and read those two chapters, I gave you a quick overview of it just now. But go back and read it, starting with the Beatitudes. Blessed are peacemakers. Blessed are those who mourn. To one being salt and light. And what is salt and light? Salt gives flavor to food. It adds something to it. We are supposed to add to the world. Jesus' love is what we're supposed to add. And we're supposed to be light. Light, if you're in a dark room and you click on a little flashlight or you light a candle, what happens to the darkness? It goes away. So that one little candlelight is enough light to banish the darkness away. That's what we're supposed to be in the world. It's not about judging others. It's not about making sure that everybody is doing the right thing. It's about understanding who God has called us to be and knowing that we're supposed to love one another as Christ loved us. And did Christ wait for us to get it right? Did Christ wait for us to get everything in order before we came to him and he loved us? No. He loves us the way we are. And he loves us enough to not leave us the way that we are. To help bring us further. To help us base our life on the rock that is him, right? On a sure and stable foundation. If you've ever built a sandcastle, you know that that's not stable, right? If you've ever lived in California or know anybody that lived in California, even a concrete foundation may not be stable, right? But the earth has a tendency to do this in California. It shakes. So earthquakes can take apart a rock foundation. Even rocks will not stand. But if you can base your life on what Christ has told us in the Beatitudes and do the things that he's done for us, for the rest of the world out there, I guarantee you that he's always going to be with you and always walk with you. It doesn't mean that things are going to be easy. There's still going to be problems in the world. But if you can base your life on Christ and what he's taught us and tried to tell us to do, by example showing us through teachings that he gave to those people and he gave to us in the Sermon on the Mount, then we will be salt and light and help to bring others to that loving relationship that he has with each other. So, know that even though we're fools, because we still build on the sand, that Christ is always going to be there for us and love us and help us to move our lives over onto Him as a rock and a sure foundation.